Hello there, it's me, Dora. Well, today I thought maybe we will talk a little bit. I will answer a question again, because I do get them, you know. And this one is again from the same fellow. You know the one who had trouble with the rubber boots? He was very concerned that his wife would get upset. Well, you could look that up in my video, so you'll find that one out. Well, here again, he has a troubles here. And again, he's a little bit worried about his wife not being upset. So I will help him out today. He was going to make supper. Oh, great. He was supposed to do the porkies. They were frozen in the fridge, in the freezer. Well, he took them out, apparently, and he put them on the cupboard. It sounds like that. And they all, I forgot. And you know what happens with the frozen pierogies? They all froze together and became one huge pierogi. Well, you know, I want to first say to this gentleman that you're not the first person that has ever happened to. And you won't be the last, because that also happened to me, Dora. Yes, it did. And I'm going to just share with you what I did. Right or wrong, I don't know. But anyways, what I did, I took that big clump out of the bag, of course, and I boiled a big pot of water. Then I threw that big clump of pierogies in there. I did not want to chop it up into pieces, because then the potatoes would all get loose, you know, in the water, and just get it would be a mess. So this is what I did. In the meantime, while that is boiling, don't wait for them to come to the top, believe me, unless some break apart, but not much happens there if they're frozen, if they're really glued together. They're not going to float to the top, so you're not going to know when they're ready, really. So let them boil for a while. In the meantime, I chop up some onions and put butter. Butter and onions is the secret ingredient of pierogies, really. Because what you want, and salted butter, never, I'm sorry, but no margarine, please. Just butter and lots of it, because you're going to pour them on the pierogi after. That's what you do if you're boiling them, but this is a little bit different story right now. So now, what you're going to do is you're going to let that boil for a while. Then you're going to take it out. And that's when you're going to let it cool a little bit. And then you're going to chop it up into lots of little pieces. Chop, 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 okay? And if you wanted, you could add a little bit of bacon as well to when you're frying up the onions, whatever your taste is. So then, now this is what, now you take all that chopped up stuff and this, and then you put it in the big frying pan and you fry it up with the onions and the butter. Or you could just put butter and then pour that other mixture on top later, whatever. I just fried mine in there. And it got them nice and crispy, all these nice little pieces. Nom, 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 nom. Then I dug them out, poured them nice on a nice platter, and then you serve that with sour cream. And I want to just say to this gentleman today, really, your wife will think that's wonderful. She really will. And act like you had it planned right from the very beginning. She might even ask, how do you make them like this, honey? Anyways, that's my tip for today. And, there's some of you right now. I can heal it. I can feel it. I mean, you're saying, I think I'll take out my bag of pierogies and I'm just going to let them glue together and try out your recipe. No, 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 don't do that. Well, maybe you could. I didn't say you should, but whatever. All right, goodbye for now. I love you. See you soon, and God bless.